Lodestone Arctic Edge has been located this time on a rugged snowy mountain.
We've brought the Motorstorm franchise across to the PSP, trying to bring everything that you see in the PS3 versions across intact. Your ragdolls, your crazy crashes, all the events going on around the player, spectacular explosions, and the difference this time is it's in an Arctic environment.
It's not moved away from what Motorstorm was, it's just taking it and just bring it to a new level by just adding new exciting things.
Specifically in the tracks, there's multiple routes. Different routes have different levels of danger and specialities for different classes of vehicles.
There's 12 tracks in the game, scaling up the side of the mountain, going from low to high, gravelly tracks all the way up to the snowy tracks.
The lower down tracks, which tend to be more mud and gravel and that kind of thing, so they tend to be a bit more slidey, and they're also a bit more open as well.
Going higher up, you get more of the snow and ice introduced, and the top level is pretty much pure snow and ice.
The last set of tracks are set at the very top of the mountain, where it's all very snowy, so you've got things like avalanches, you've got heavy snowstorms, all these kind of things add to that Arctic feel.
At certain stages on certain tracks, you enter what we like to call danger zones, whereby triggering certain events you can cause rock slides to occur. So if you're in a pretty good position up in the race and you want to consolidate that position, you can trigger one of these events and it will wipe out everybody behind you.
We've got ice bridges that'll break if you drive over with a big rig. We've got bobsleigh corners, which are kind of cool, because once you go onto those, you've got no traction, so it's all about boosting and hitting the corner at the right angle.
The tracks are reversible. Anything from Motorstorm can race them in both directions.
Designing the tracks to work in both directions obviously had its limitations, because you couldn't have a massive fall-off in, you know, a 200-metre drop, because you have to get back up there the other side. So you had to be clever and think around that.
The Motorstorm series is known for its multi-route track design. That's something we tried to carry through to Arctic Edge. We began by looking at the actual environments in Alaska and seeing how we could adapt the visuals to match that.
We predominantly modelled in 3DS Max and we created textures from the reference photographs using Adobe Photoshop. The limitations of the software means there was polygon limits, but we tried to push it as much as we could. We had a bar at the bottom of the PSP dev kit which showed us the performance as we were to drive around the levels, so we could target specific key areas with more polygons and get it running in frame really nicely.
We've put a heck of a lot of work into getting the very best possible visuals we can out of the PSP. The program's done an excellent job and we really have pushed this thing to the absolute limit. You've got mud, you've got dust everywhere on the screen. It's just an absolute riot on wheels.
プレイステーション。